Hello and good morning to you. I'm Neil from Bath Cars. That's actually very irrelevant with today's little sale. And this is a great sad point for me because I've had these loudspeakers for many, many years in my 20s and I'm really reluctant to sell them. But I've moved them from my flat into this workshop that I've rented for a while. They've barely been used in here. I don't really want to end up having to carry them back to the flat and just put them back into storage again. So here they are then, up for sale is two pairs, four speakers, Celestion Ditton 55-1s, vintage 1970s retro type hi-fi speakers with 12-inch subwoofers, bass reflex ported, mid-range and tweeters with crossover adjustments, finished in a light wood finish, elm I would suggest. Is it elm? I can't remember what they were. Actually, they're not walnut, I don't think, but they're a light wood finish. The grills are missing from all four pairs. I don't think we have them any longer. I used to work in a hi-fi shop in Bath for 5 years, in my early 20s, late teens. And I collected my first pair, then I got a second pair. And they've been through pretty much all my life, really. Unfortunately, the right-hand side set here fell off this bloody tubing and managed to crack the cabinet, so one of them's got a fairly hefty bit of damage to the cabinet up the top here, and I don't think it's affected the sound that much, but they're really well built. They're about 50 kilos a piece, and they're quite heavy if I remember rightly. I think they're all 18 kilos, I think. This one's got a bit of damage to the corner. The rear connections on the back are just standard spade connections. I think the 4mm will fit in the back there. There's your inspection plates there, 8 ohms, Ipswich. In the high days of British hi-fi, when we made a really good quality product, I'm pretty sure that one pair's been 79 strand, QED 79 strand upgraded. That looks like that one there, and probably one of the other ones as well. Right, there is a pair of stands to go with these as well. So there's a pair of Target stands that I'll tag on at the end of this, which I had specially made for them, and they were pretty expensive in their day. They're white. Now, let's just give them a little test a moment. The radio station with a bit of... This is one pair. So the woofer, the tweeter in the mid-range working okay on that. Sometimes these can be a little bit crackly, but that one's okay. Yeah, all three are working on that one as well. Try the Asuna pair. The tweeter's not working on that one, and the crossover appears to be a little bit. The mid-range is working on that one. So you've got a tweeter gone on that pair, on that one. Yeah, and those three are fine on that one. So out of all the four, there's one tweeter gone, so whether or not it's actually just its wires falling off the back of this crossover, quite likely, because it's taken a fair bash there and it does feel a little bit loose. So I think I've got one of those crossovers spare somewhere. I'm pretty sure I have. Okay, so that tweeter's not working. But on full chat with a proper bit of proper sound input, these things sound really, really awesome in here. I must admit, it's been quite a pleasure to have them. Right, so none of the amplifications included. That's just, unless you want to make me an offer on this Radford amplifier as well, they fetch some reasonable money, and he sounds okay. Probably could do with a service on the sliders, but he's working fine. And yeah, if you're interested in that Trio amp, you can have that as well. So see what you can work out for that. And don't forget to have a look at the stands.